You have any plans for weekend Liberty, Jack?
My sisters have been working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before Liberty.
Good job, Kelso.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection! It'd better be exceptional if any of you want Liberty this weekend. Kelso, this carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend Liberty canceled. 2-day field drill.
Clean this rifle.
No.
Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished?
Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
That bum took a swipe at me. I put him down with my sap.
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up to a 45. I want to put him down one round.
Isn't he a cop who won the medal in the Solvanoff cases?
A week to get an ID.
I don't want to be rude, but I ain't got time for talk.
Straight through.
Looks like the DA is going to press charges. And Rodriguez might do time.
I'll speak to the DA. It's yourself.
I don't know, Cole. She's an easy make, and the DA likes convictions.
I'll convince him to let her go.
How do you do that?
I'll give him something better.
Detectives, over here.
Cole Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
Thick as a white male, name of Lester Patterson. Walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar, name of Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old, she left Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so?
We'll take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
Phelps?
You should take... Landed on his face and ended up here. Car must have struck him from behind.
Madison has life insurance.
We can notify next of kin. What have you got on the victim?
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident. I don't know how intoxicated once I'd done the autopsy. Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest wound? Isn't that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers. Careful where you're stepping, Phelps. I don't come down to the station house and tap dance on your desk.
Body traveled a good 20 feet.
Blood is a long way from the body. The car must have been going like a bat out of hell. Find anything interesting?
So the driver managed to brake before the impact.
He's all yours, Detective.
I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Your name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
Okay. What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
So you didn't see what happened?
By the time I got out there, it was all over.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah. Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
I'm at a loss. Witness statements next. We know we've got the girl as an eyeball, but we should check the bar as well. Miss Perry?
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski. Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well, there were two voices. A man and a woman, that's all.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
I'm sorry. I was hoping to tell my story to the newspapers. I'd like to get my picture in the paper. I'm trying to find work as an actress, and things are pretty difficult.
Cough it up, sister. We don't have all night.
People arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
You certainly got away with the dames, Phelps.
Give it a rest, Bukowski.
Let's see what the patrons have to say.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
What was it about?
Who knows? The slightest thing could set those two off.
Stalling just makes us more inquisitive, Lynch. We'll get to the bottom of this, with or without you. That guy has a serious attitude problem.
You get anything out of the regulars? They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the love tap.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, Detective. Only one possible make on that license. Registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thanks for your help.
Looks like we caught a break on this one.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
And where exactly are we going?
Yes? Hello?
Mrs. Patterson.
Is this about my husband?
We're investigating the incident, ma'am.
I see. Come in, won't you?
We wanted to give you the facts about the accident, ma'am.
I appreciate that, but I think I know most of them already, Detective. He was hit by a car, now he's dead. More is there to tell.
Pardon me, but you don't appear to be too upset about it.
Lester and I met on a furlough in 44. We got married that weekend. People don't understand it now, but that happened a lot back then.
I see. So you probably did well to stick together this long.
What's that supposed to mean, mister? I think it's about time you left. I have someone here, and
I... Beg your pardon? You're gonna have to run that one by us again, sister.
It's okay, Lorna. I'm Leroy Sabo.
Well, well. Nice to see you're comforting the grieving widow, Mr. Sabo.
All right, wise guy. Do you have any intelligent questions you would like me to answer?
You can confirm Mrs. Patterson's story.
Lester lost at cards. He was kind of hard to control when he lost his temper. He turned without looking and walked right out in front of the car. It wasn't good.
What's your relationship with Mrs. Patterson, Mr. Sabo?
We're friends. Good friends.
You expect me to believe that?
Look, I was filing for divorce. Mental cruelty. Lester could be a mean son of a bitch.
And Lester knew about that?
No. I hadn't told him.
Well, hasn't this worked out well for the two of you? I feel almost bad for busting in on this little rendezvous.
How did the car come to hit Lester?
He walks straight into the path of an oncoming car.
You expect me to believe that, Lorna? It's all very convenient.
Gambling for Lester was like the needle for a hophead. He was yelling at me. He was yelling at the whole world. I kind of felt sorry for the driver. Poor guy had no chance.
You were arguing in the bar and on the sidewalk?
We were always arguing. So what?
Don't lie to me. Something was different this time.
You're clutching at straws. You married? The arguments are never any different.
We're leaving, Lorna, but this doesn't add up. We'll be keeping an eye on you.
Come on, Phelps. Let's make ourselves scarce.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Messages for me, please.
Just one, Detective, from the coroner. Message reads, Phelps, see me at Central Morgue immediately. Results of the Pattison autopsy.
Thanks.
I'm out of here, Lorna. I got a business to run.
Can you drive to this one?
Where are we going?
It's a lucky break getting a partial ID. These cases are usually dead in the water after 24 hours if no one comes forward.
Why don't they just stop?
You heard about fight or flight during the war?
Sure. Never back your enemy into a corner. That kind of stuff.
Right. Well, in a hit and run, the perp is already in flight. It's easier to keep going. It takes a degree of moral courage to stop and accept responsibility.
You're not as dumb as you make yourself out to be, are you, Stefan?
Right there. William Shelton?
Yes?
It doesn't look good, Shelton. You packing your bags and making a run for it? You know why we're here.
Yes. The accident.
We've got witnesses who can put this car at the scene, not to mention the physical damage. This is open and shut, Shelton.
Howard thinks he can run from everything.
Lay into his wheel, Archie. Come on.
Driving like this.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
Don't let that asshole get away.
Where'd you learn how to drive?
All right, I give up.
Stop driving like a damn fool.
That's it. Cuff them and we're done.
Give it up, LAPD! That was a vehicular manslaughter rap sound, Shelton.
I hit him I admit it, I just panicked, but it wasn't my fault.
What do you mean?
The guy jumped right out in front of me. He came out of nowhere. There's nothing I could do about it.
Why didn't you stop?
I've had accidents before.
That's it. We're done here. DA is gonna love you.
They weren't all my fault. I'm a surveyor. I need my license for my job. There were people around. A woman and a man were standing right next to him. I thought they could get him to a hospital. I'm telling you, it's not my fault.
The guy is dead, Shelton.
You can't be serious.
William Shelton, you're coming downtown. We need to talk about a manslaughter charge.
Pulling luxury. Another?
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Do we know where we're going?
KZI is a member of the American Century Broadcasting Network.
We could put the driver in front of a judge in less than a week.
You'd be making a big mistake.
Run that by me again?
The victim was dead before the car hit him. Two puncture wounds to the right side of the thorax. Second puncture reached his heart.
You're kidding me.
Been doing this job 23 years, son. No one's ever laughed at one of my jokes.
He was stabbed to death?
Long, sharp knife. Length of a bayonet.
So the hit and run was a cover-up?
I'd say he was stabbed twice at very close quarters. Both wounds thrusting upwards and then pushed in front of the car.
Easy, Tiger.
Clever, really. I almost missed it. But the trajectory of the wounds was all wrong if he was impaled by the hood ornament. Find the knife, detectives.
Yes, sir.
It all comes back to the crime scene. We need to hit Ray's one more time and trawl for evidence.
You know the way. You can drive.
All right. Where to?
So there was some truth to Sheldon's cock and bull story after all.
Didn't stop, but he didn't kill Patterson either.
I'm no betting man, but I know where I'd put all my chips.
The grieving widow and her shoulder to cry on.
Now all we need is a murder weapon.
Lester could be a heel, but
crime scene over one more time.
That's a lousy way for anyone.
If that's all tight.
Can you be quick about it? Cops are bad for business.
Really? We'll tiptoe, Sabo. You won't even notice us. All right. Step by step, check every inch of ground.
Have a seat.
Thanks, Doctor.
How are you finding working at the clinic?
It's, fine.
Are you sure?
Can I be honest with you, Doctor?
I would hope so, Courtney.
I was hoping that the therapy would be more beneficial.
Treatment can, unfortunately, be very long-term.
So many of the patients here are addicts, Doctor.
Many of them have been for years, Courtney. In the past, these people were condemned to sanatoriums. If we can reveal the root of the problem, then we have a chance to help them.
And until then, they stay sedated?
Do I detect a hint of reproach, Courtney?
I was expecting more, Doctor. I'm sorry. I don't mean to criticize.
Part of being a physician, Courtney, is learning to be patient.
How is it possible to keep so many of them on their medications, Doctor? Many of their addictions are illegal.
Oh, many things in life are gray, Courtney. What may on the surface appear to be illegal is actually of benefit to society at large.
This is why everybody comes to Ray's. Any ideas?
You're the bloodhound, Phelps. See what you can sniff out. Lester could be a heel, but that's a lousy way for anyone to go out.
Help me out.
All right. Step by step, check every inch of ground.
I'm sure Carruthers will confirm. confirm this as the murder weapon. Let's talk to Leroy. See him explain his way out of this. Leroy Sabo, you're under arrest for the murder of Lester Patterson.
Not gonna happen, fellas.
Go! I'll bring the car around and head him off. It's too late, Sabo.
So, I give you a hit and run, you bring me back fraud, conspiracy, and first-degree murder. This is how a good detective operates, Phelps. You take nothing at face value. You keep digging and asking questions until you get to the truth. You got some sharp elbows on you, detective. I like that. Keep up the good work.